What's up? This is Jeremy Camp with House FM.
Hey, what's up? This is Tauren Wells.
Hey, I'm Ann Wilson.
Hey, it's Micah Tyler.
Hey, guys, it's Tasha Layton.
Hey, everybody, this is Gareth from Rand Collective.
Hey, guys, it's Blanca here with the House FM.
Hey, I'm Matthew West.
Hey, my name's Austin French.
Hey, guys, this is We the Kingdom.
The House ministry is really affecting the world. You guys are making a difference in Oklahoma, and I know what an impact Christian radio has made in my life. Being an artist and hearing stories all the time, I know lots of testimonies of people where, man, they were just on the brink. They heard a song and decided not to end their life, or they needed hope when they left the hospital and had a diagnosis. It's just, you never know what Christian radio is going to impact because, you know, it reaches places we can't go. People at their work, in their car, on the job. And so let's support one another. I can't do what I do without the House, and they can't do what they do without me, and neither of us can do what we do without you guys. So let's support the House ministry in Oklahoma.
Christian radio means so much to me for multiple reasons. I've heard lots of stories from people and people that have listened to the station, but I think the greatest thing for me is when my kids, I remember when they were younger, my daughter was singing, You're an overcomer. And she's singing that over and over again. And I remember saying to Mandisa, thank you for that song because my kids were singing this and they heard it on the radio. And to hear them saying that was one of the most encouraging things. So I love the stories that I heard from people, but my kids and my family being touched by it means the most for sure. You know, one of the things that I want to encourage you guys is that we truly have a God who sees us and loves us and knows every single thing about us. I love the scripture that says that before I even formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. So he sees you, he loves you, and he thinks about you more than the sands of the sea. So just trust him.
And we really believe in the power of Christian radio. The amount of stories that we have got, one story that jumps out is that our family basically who had separated and split up and the dad was leaving, whenever he got into his car to drive away from his family and he said he would never be back, he actually ended up listening to one of our songs on radio and pulled over the side of the road in tears, gave his life to Jesus, drove home, and his family has been changed ever since. That's the power of bringing the message of the gospel into the homes and the cars of people. And we love the House FM. They have a heart to see the gospel put forward, to see lives transformed. And that's really what we're here for, isn't it? So we really believe that supporting that, getting behind that, is what we need to do as a church and we need to do as Christians. Because if we're not going to raise up the truth in this day and age, then who will? So please support, and we love you guys.
I am such a supporter of Christian radio. I think of my own journey. I didn't get to know really a deep relationship with God till I was about 17, 18 years old. And I remember at that time just having all these mind battles of who I thought I was and needing that truth that came through music. For me was an avenue that spoke to my heart. So being able to turn on the radio and listen to songs that had such a strong message of who I really was, was necessary, was very necessary at that time in that 17-year-old girl's heart. So keep supporting, keep loving on your radio station. It's making such a huge impact. It did in me, and now I get to do this. So thank you, House of Fenn, for your support on my songs, and much love to all you guys.
So thankful for the impact of Christian radio, and as a Christian artist, somebody who's decided to spend his life writing songs, telling people about Jesus, we couldn't do that without the help of stations like House FM. So if you've been ministered to by a song about Jesus that you heard on this radio station, I want to encourage you to just consider how you can help pay that forward and help other people continue to hear about the message of the gospel through one Jesus song after the other. So God bless y'all.
Well, I grew up listening to Christian radio my whole life. My mom and dad had it in on the car, and so that's something that's always been really impactful for me. I think just growing up and knowing that every time I would get in the car, no matter how bad of a day it was or how good of a day it was, that Christian radio was playing and that the hope of Jesus was playing in the car, that was always just really amazing for me. And then there's just a quick story. I'll just summarize it really quick. But my brother passed away in 2017, and we were devastated. It was so tragic. He died in a car accident on impact. And as we were driving to go look at his truck at the towing company, we stopped for my dad to get a drink at McDonald's. And my mom turns on Christian radio, and the song Even If by Mercy Me comes on. And we had never heard that song before. And the lyrics, the first line is, sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some, but right now And then it goes on. And then the chorus is just so good about saying, like, even if you don't do this, God, even if you don't make a miracle out of this, even if you don't heal us, we're still going to trust you. And that was just a moment that really forever changed the trajectory of our grief journey and our, like, decision to trust God and not being on our own understanding during that time. So Christian radio just means a lot to me. I've listened to it my whole life, and it's something that I still turn to when I'm having a hard day or a good day or whatever. I love to listen to it.
Thank you for supporting Christian Radio, The House. I love these guys. I have an agenda. It's because they play my song so I can do what I do. But I'm so grateful to get to partner with these guys, to get to partner with you. I was raised on Christian radio when I was a new believer. I found a local Christian radio station that I tuned into every day, and it discipled me, you know. And so I want to encourage you, you know, as you give to the station, you aren't just giving to a radio station. You're giving to a kid like me that when he needed hope, he found it on the radio dial, and it shaped the rest of his life. So thank you for giving.
And I tell you, we are so thankful for radio ministry. I remember, like it was yesterday, hearing Praise You in the Storm, Come On, in Nashville, where I live. I'd just woken up, my wife's alarm went off, and it went off to Christian radio. And I was going through a really tough season, and I remember in that dark moment, hearing the promise of the truth of God's word in that song, that he was with me in the middle of that battle I was fighting. It really changed my day and changed the trajectory of my life. I'm so thankful that we've got the privilege to be involved in radio. So grateful for all the people that support it. So thank you for the stations, and just grateful.
Well, I'm always blown away to hear how music moves people, how music meets people, and how God uses it to help people in, like, the best moments of their lives and in the worst moments of their lives. And I will never forget hearing the story of Hills and Valleys. And it was this girl, a young girl, who was on her deathbed, and the last song she wanted to hear was Hills and Valleys. And that's what was playing as she transitioned from time into eternity. And then at the same time, like, to think of something that feels so tragic, you know. I had someone tell me that Hills and Valleys was the first song that they played for their child when they were born in the hospital. And so to think that these songs meet people in the spectrum of life like that,
just wherever they are,
it's really incredible to me. And I've been on the receiving end of this ministry, of what radio can do, and what partnerships from the listener to the radio to the artists and songwriters can do to just amplify hope.
When I think about the impact of Christian radio, I think about a farmer. A story that we've heard in scripture probably over and over again, a message that Jesus preached, is about the sower and the seed. The sower who has all this farmer going out with all these seeds, and he is casting seeds apparently everywhere, because some seeds are falling on the sidewalk and the birds come and pick them up. Some of the seeds fall into the cracks and they go just deep enough where all of a sudden they start to take root, but there's not enough space for them to go any deeper and they shrivel up and die. There's somewhere they fall in thorn bushes, and as they start to come up, the thorns grab them and try to take them away, and sometimes it falls on the good soil. For years, I just thought that that meant that I had to find the good soil to put the seed in. There was only select places that I can go and offer the seed. But what I'm thinking about more right now is I'm thinking about that farmer. I'm thinking about the fact that he is not caring what the soil could be. He just wants to see something grow. He's not being reckless by throwing seeds all over the place, apparently like in city streets, but also in country fields. He is just going out there and not being reckless with that seed. He is being relentless because he just wants to see something take root. See, Christian radio does not decide where their signal goes. Your Christian radio station is sending out the gospel to anyone and everyone, not deciding what soil is good enough to get it, but knowing that the seed is good enough to give. So when you partner with Christian radio stations, you are not saying, man, I just hope they play good songs. It's saying there is a good God that's worth singing about and a good gospel that can change anybody. So right now, join in with your local Christian radio station, so that you can see something grow in your own backyard.
Christian radio means so much to me. I was a jaded kid. I was 13 years old. I had given up on the church. I'd been hurt by the church. And I didn't want to be around anybody who loved Jesus. But then I gave my life to Jesus when I was 13, but still had a lot of bitterness in my heart. And I remember turning on the radio and heard the song called If We Are the Body by Casting Crowns Come On. I began to just weep in my car with my mom, who both of us had experienced a lot of hurt. And I looked at her and I said, maybe the church is full of broken people just like us who need Jesus. And that song and that moment is the reason I'm doing Christian music today, is I fell in love with the broken people who need a savior just like me, just like you. And Christian music is an opportunity for people to realize that, number one, we all need Jesus. And number two, that Jesus' word will heal us in the music form. So Christian radio means a lot to me. I believe in it, and I think that's why you should support it, because you could be a part of changing someone else's life, just like my life has changed.